Good afternoon, everyone. You are on with Caitlin from Banger Inc. Today, we're going to be talking about how to create parts in Stage 100 Contractor. So follow with me. Let's open our sample company. And this is only going to be relevant if your company has purchased the estimating module. So that is not part of the core software itself, but it's an add-on that you guys can purchase if you guys track estimating parts in your software. So once you've purchased the estimating module, navigate over on the left-hand side to the estimating number 9 dropdown and select parts. This will pop up to the first part where you will enter in your part information. For this calculation field, it's going to default to the next numerical value that is available. So if you have no parts in there, you can go ahead and start with number 1. For my example, I have a bunch of parts from the sample company. So I'm going to choose a number that's not already selected. This example, we'll use 50,000. Here, I've already generated a part for this number called test. In the description field, this is going to be a required field that needs to be entered before you can save your record. So give this record a name for the part itself that you'll want to track when you build your takeoff. The next required field is going to be the unit of measure. So this you can create on your own. This can be each, per square foot, lineal foot, anything that your company uses to measure these items will be what you select in the unit. You can also use the dropdown and use the ones that have already been used in the software itself, or you can create your own. You'll want to keep this consistent across similar parts. The alpha part number isn't a required field, but this is something that you guys can track for your vendor part number if you guys purchase them from vendors. The next part is the part class or the grouping of parts that it will be found under. So whenever you do your dropdown, it'll group items by class structure. There'll be a separate video on how to create part classes and assembly classes later on. With this part, you'll want to assign a cost code so that when you create your budget, all of the like items under the same cost code are grouped together for budgetary reasons. So here, you'll already have selected a cost code that is where you want to group the value for this part. If you haven't set up cost codes, that will be where you want to start. And here on the cost type, you'll denote if you are going to have it labeled as a material item, a labor item, equipment, or subcontract, or other. If you need to create other cost types, feel free to do so by hitting the vented arrow that says View Add Records, or by pushing F6. That way, you can label these appropriately to assign them to tax districts that will then tax those items if they're needing to add tax to them. The next item is the taskbar. That is strictly for scheduling on our Gantt charts. So you'll want to put a task that is associated to that part. Depending on the tasks that are already inputted in the system, you'll want to select which one is applicable. So if I wanted to put this as my planning task, this will be the first task that goes on my Gantt from this part. If you don't have tasks already set up in the system, that'll be another spot that will need to be entered before you can proceed with this. However, anything down here in the general information tab is not needed in order to save the record. It's just strictly additional information. The next tab is cost, billing, and ordering, and this is where you will put in the default cost for that part. Remember, anything that is considered a part is something that just needs to have a monetary value tied to it when making your bid. So that can be a labor item, that can be an equipment cost, or that can truly be the cost of material for the bid. If you don't know, the only reason that you would put in this default cost is so whenever you select this part on your takeoff, it'll pre-populate the default cost. So all you would need to do is update the amount of the quantity that you need for the total bid. If you don't know, you can definitely just leave it blank or put in $1 and update it on the grid later. You also have the option to put on a markup percent. So so that it bills the customer a specific dollar amount that's above the cost price. The next item over is labor. So you can put on a labor part that would associate this part of the test in our example. The labor part, that would be for man hours. So then you can type in how many man hours it would take to complete that part. The other two options down here, inventory and service equipment, are part of add-on modules. So if your company does not manage inventory or have the service receivables module, these tabs will not show up for your company. If this was an item that you needed to track for inventory, you will put on the inventory location that it's stored in, typically a warehouse or something similar. And then this is where you can see at any given point how many items you have on hand, which would then equate to a dollar amount for your inventory on the GL. If this part is going to be subcontracted, so let's say that this test is now going to be, we're going to sub this work out. We have the option to add in vendors at our preference for each part. So if I want Gray Heating and Cooling to do the work for this, I'll update them. And whenever I put this on the takeoff, it'll pull through Gray Heating and Cooling to do this work. So then I can export my subcontract directly from the grid. We'll go into exporting later, but this is how to enter a basic part in Stage 100 to then put into your takeoff as part of the estimating module. And once you're done, save that record and it will go blank. If you ever need to look back at the record that you just saved, hit the recall button and it'll bring you right back to where you were. If you have any questions or want to dive deeper, please feel free to give me a call or email me at coordinator@bangerinc.com. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel, and I look forward to talking with you guys. Thanks.